There is a whole lot to know about Android testing. Honestly, we could and probably should make an entire course on how to do it well. Let's just look into how to run tests and when to use unit tests versus connected tests. We've defined a super simple project with this class Echo. It has a method that just returns whatever you put into it. It also has another version of Echo where it first logs whatever you input and then returns it. We've also added a product flavor to this project. In the paid folder, we've got paid Echo, which does essentially the same thing, but for collections instead of single objects. So we have this collection Echo that just echoes back whatever you put in, and then this version of Echo that first logs each item that you put in. So we've defined some tests in the test directory. These are JUnit tests, and so we just verify that Echo is in fact behaving how we expect, and that the logging version of Echo is behaving how we expect. To test the paid flavor in the test paid folder, we have another pair of extremely simple JUnit tests that just verify that the echo of the collection works as expected and that the echoing of the collection with logging works as expected. All of this code is in the course repository, so you can get a closer look there. If we open up the Gradle pane and run the check task, let's see what happens when we run these tests. Uh-oh, we have failing tests. We can check out the report at this file path to see what went wrong. So here we are at app build reports tests free debug index.html. And here's our report of what went wrong. Let's see, method I in Android util log, not mocked. So I think I know what's going wrong here. We tried to use the Android logger from a unit test. Now, the Android framework doesn't exist when we're running unit tests, since those are being run on the local machine. If we want to test something that is accessing the Android framework, we have to run those on the device. Let's move those into connected tests instead of unit tests. So we'll comment out the tests that require the Android framework. Comment this one out too. And now we'll add our connected tests to the Android test directory. Note that this is an Android test case now instead of a JUnit test. And we can add our paid tests to the Android test paid directory. Now if we open up the Gradle pane and run connected check, then there we go. The tests that require accessing the Android framework run on the device where the Android framework is available, and they all pass.